So you want to start collecting one-time payments from your customers by just sending them a link, as you're not actually ready to write any code yet. You see that Stripe offers both a payment link and an invoice option with a hosted invoice page. So which of these is right for your use case? In this episode, you're going to learn the differences of both, and we'll take a look at when you might use each. There's a couple important things to keep in mind when you're deciding between a hosted invoice and a payment link. Do you have a specific customer in mind? Do you need it to be reusable? And do you need a custom payment flow? Do you really need to customize that payment flow very much? So let's dig into each of those. Specific customer, do you have a specific customer in mind? So invoices are directly related to a specific customer that you typically know about before you even create the invoice. So you might create an invoice, for instance, for a coaching client with your billable hours for a specific project. Payment links, on the other hand, are related to specific products and prices, but they're not tied to a customer when you're actually creating the payment link. So you would create a payment link to sell something like an ebook or a course or something where you didn't actually know who the customers are yet. Next up, is it reusable? So each invoice has a unique Stripe-hosted page where you can redirect customers to pay their invoice. And once the invoice is paid for, that unique page it's not really reusable for other customers, right? So the URL for a hosted invoice page is gonna be unique per invoice. Payment link, on the other hand, is reusable. You can send the same payment link to all your customers, and each one will go through the payment process via the same link, and you'll get paid multiple times. Let's talk about the custom payment flow. You can use the invoicing APIs to create an invoice and bill a customer with code. If you want to automate more of your invoicing and billing system, you can customize invoices and have them collect payment automatically or send an email invoice to the customer. Invoices can have custom fields, they can have memos, footers, flexible invoice numbering schemes, and they can even include one or many of your tax IDs. This is a requirement in many countries. As of this recording, payment links are dashboard only, but we'd love to add an API to create payment links, so stay tuned and let us know if that's something that you're interested in. This means that today you'll need to use the Stripe dashboard to create payment links when you want to sell a new product or service. Every day, the payment links are becoming more and more customizable, so head over to the documentation and see what you can add to a payment link today. Both invoices and payment links support Stripe Connect, and they enable you to build platforms and marketplaces where you can facilitate payment on behalf of other businesses, sellers, and vendors. Fulfillment. So for both invoicing and payment links, fulfillment is done via webhooks. Take a look at those docs for the list of webhook event types that you'll want to monitor for each. That's a wrap for our comparison of invoices and payment links. Again, you're going to use an invoice if you know the specific customer ahead of time, you know exactly how much you're going to charge that customer, and you don't need that to be reusable. That's a one-time thing between you and the customer. And you're going to use a payment link if you want to create a payment link that's tied to a specific product that you want to sell over and over to customers that you don't actually know yet. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.